My name is Luke, and I will show you some aspects of this machine. I have bought the machine a few years ago, and I use it for the milling, grinding anvils, and also for the lathe tools. But the funny thing is always there in the drawer is this tool here. So there are no marks on it, no scales, nothing. So this winter I have to do some exercise and see how that this thing is working. And also what I have done to work it better. So the first, when this machine I have bought, the first two things that I have done is to set here an angle iron between the lamp here and the tube, and also create one easy one key to disconnect the stone and change the stone from the grinding. And the improvement of this tool is only a few things, is this little plate here. This plate must be, I have milled 1 millimeter away from this flange with this direction of the line here goes to the is parallel with the cone axis. That's this one here with the axis of this cone, and that must be correct, because in the old, the original thing, the plate was turning always and you don't know which corner that you must have. Here you see a sketch of the drill grinder tooling for the UT3 tool grinder. It is a Chinese copy of the Dekel SO grinder. Dus what we have here this axis from 12 mm is the cone axis. That's one axis. The grinder axis lie in this direction, and the drill is located in this direction. This drawing is drawn in a position that the drill is at the highest position of the swiveling of the cone. So what we have here, this is the axis of the cone, and if it is on the highest position, the cutting edge will make contact with the cone. And then if you go lower, then the cutting edge with the cone will touch the relief angle. So there are two settings that must be done with this tool. First, the XD, that is the cutting corner, how much it must be held before the tool holder itself. And then the XT is the top of the drill, how much we must shift the V cone, the V clamping ding. So, but to understand this XD, we must go to how it is built and see what is just happening here inside. Dus waar de drill is positioned en wat happened with the relief angle en how it is done with the ductless grinder. So I want to go to the other layer and here we can see what has happened. Dus I have enlarged this drawing. Dus we have here an angle of 7.5 degrees. And that matched mostly all the cutting edges from each type of drill will be meet the cone axis here. Dus I have drawn here three drills, one of 5 mm, one of 10 mm and one of 15 mm. And you see the drill of 10 mm is lying on the cone and also this from 5 mm. This from 15 mm is a little bit shifted. That can be because that means the chisel angle is of the chisel part is not on each drill the same, so that make a little differences according the factory of the drills. So what we must have, if you see, the cone axis lay a little bit above the V axis here. And that means that it below here at this side, it will be relieved as a cone, and before it will be flat on the initial relief angle. Thus, you must always see that we are above the cone axis. That means we must have some flat area on the top of the drill. And this flat must be around between the 10 and the 20 degrees. If you are more shifting, your drill will give more friction at the bottom. So, a little bit friction, it may stabilize the drill and it will cut better. So, I have adapted this tool to have the edge of the plate here, of the holding plate, in line with the cone axis. So, we are two tenths above the V. So that means if we want to add 10 degrees, then we must shift, the drill a little bit in front, so that you can turn the 10 degrees. And this shift is defined by, you have 180 degrees and you measure the pitch of the helix angle of the spire. This pitch between two cutting edges, you measure this one because that's valid for 180 degrees. So, and we've divided by 18 and then you have a shift of 10 degrees. Also, or divide by 9 and you have a shift of 20 degrees. The tea stand must be always there. Dus dat we have here a flat on the top. And after the flat, the cone will start. Dus we have seen this XD dimension, how it is moving with the Helix angle. And then we must see where we put our azimuth of the cone. Normally, the old pot tool from the tool grinder of pots, yeah, it is set to 3 times the diameter of the drill away in parallel here. So, but a good range is here between 2.4 and 4 and 3 times the diameter. So, we must then calculate this, this step here and also this step. And then you get the exact dimension where you put the whole thing, the drill and the clamping of the drill against this. So we have two settings. First this one here. And then you set is the end stop of the drill. And then you shift the whole thing with the bar and the drill itself to set the XT value. Take in mind, I have made tables for these values. If you see that the drill must be grind 1 or 2 millimeters away, because there are some broken edges. So you have to take in account to add the 1 or 2 millimeters that you must grind away with the figures that is in the table here in the XD and in the XD table. Because the good positioning is only become if you are close to the finish of the grinding. So, dus the XT value is composed by TI, that is the, depending on the cone, the size of the cone, really, and then the other value, TT, it is quite a summation of these two, is depending on the diameter of the drill itself. How large the drill diameter, how far it goes from the center of the cone where they are crossing here. To set up the tool, we use a 5C collector of 12 millimeters. We set up the tool in this way, and the pin is in the center of the frame. Give some tension, and then we will set it free in this way. So this must be turning. The relief, there are two settings here. For the relief, it must be set on zero on this side of the scale. And the corner on this one here, on the top one, is 14 degrees. And that is the normally corner of the top of the drill. So now the tool is ready. Normally I feed with the displacement of the stone. I have found here a drill of 10 millimeters who wear it out and who needs to be grinded. The first thing that we must set is how far it must be stick out of the of this iron here. Thus I measured the pitch of between two cutting edges, and there's a drill of 10 millimeter, but the pitch is around 25 millimeter. And in my table I found for 25 millimeter, and you will get a flat angle on the top. This for the fourth facet, a flat angle of 10 degrees, of 20 degrees. Then it must be stick out on the tool of 2.5 millimeters. Because the wearing is symmetrical, there are not broken things, so we don't add anything. Because normally if you must grind 2 millimeters off the grill, of the drill, then you have to add these 2 millimeters with the setting of the. So we will place the drill in the tool. So with this, we set the distance here. Thus we must have 2.7 millimeters. It is important that the end stop is on the correct place and that the drill is a little bit twisted. So normally you, how farther you go, how much the drill is twisted. So that is now set at 20 degrees. As we have the axis here of the cone, is the axis of this thing here, and it is a good start to the center here, and this must be followed. So do you have a fixed reference. So I will tension it. Not yet. Another setting is where has we to positioning the tool. So the first setting here on the for the angle, that was the XD setting, and the other setting is according the XT setting. It is always taken in care with the tool. This, it is 35.9 millimeters. So we will set 35.9, I use that meter. It must be not very precise, but try to close to use this the correct thing. So we set it on 35.9 with the depth stop. And now we can tension the drill. So we are now just at the stone here, and we can move. Now I will fix this thing here. All the rest is fixed, and the cross light, everything must be in a center. There's the dimension here also. This has no influences on the shape of the grinding. So we will start to grind one side. than the other side. Because we will fit okay with this. Now I have already contact. Tenths of a millimeter off my ground. Normal, I want to stop here on the previous one, and then we can do the other side. I will twist it blue. I'll show you what is done. And the other side is not done. So I think the first side must be a little bit more. I will go another tenth of a millimeter on the first side, because you see it is not done good. So the corner is completely done now. I hope you can see it. And now we will do the second side. You have always to twist the drill, the drill against the metal plate. So we stand on 3, we will go back some dimensions, some half millimeter will go back, and then we can start the second. As we go back to 3. We are at the 3 on this wheel, and we will add 200, 0.2 millimeters. So the first side. First pass is done now, at both. what all went. This one is beside in red is okay now, and now we will go to the first side in order to, and we will fix the stone. Don't move anything anymore. So now it is done now. Now the drill is complete, is now finished in the grinding. So we will see on the milling machine. Now we will test the grinder, the drill now, and then we will make a hole and measure it. Thank you for viewing the first part. Give a comment and subscribe to my channel. The documentation is in preparation, and when it is ready, I will add a link to the video comment. I will also thank Professor Jean Hummel from Zurich for the extra comments in my research on the cutting parameters and settings. So we are now at 10.13 millimeters. So it is quite good, and the finishing is also good in the hole. These are the chips, they come very nice and symmetrical out of the drill. And if we look at the metal piece of 10 mm thickness, if there are no birds at the top of side, but also no birds at the bottom side. It's very clean drilled, so it works very well, this machine, for grinding drills. Thank you. The next part I will talk about grinding of cobalt drills for Inox. So I want to thank you also for watching and your comments. Bye.